challenge we have in this country is about housing. And it is estimated by the minister himself, when he spoke in Cape Coast in May this year, that about 1.7 million housing deficit is what we are facing in this country. It is even estimated that by 2018, this number will rise up to a 2 million gap. And this is very serious. The challenge is something that has to be confronted frontally, both by government and the private sector, because housing at the moment is something that our Ghanaian community is suffering about handling. If you go to the various settlements now, especially new settlements in Accra, lots of houses are rising up, but no service is done on the land, and no utility services are available. It's making it very difficult, and it's making the housing that are put up in these places really, really very difficult to occupy by the occupants themselves. I want to urge the minister not just to make the statement as a policy statement, but to follow it up with practical implementation of our housing policy, which is driven from since independence to date, but which has never been frontally attacked. And we have a problem with that. Every government has a policy, but no government has fully implemented the housing policy in Ghana. The rent issue he has just mentioned, Mr. Speaker, is something that is putting Ghana aside in the rest of the world. The reason is that it is only in Ghana people pay this high rent and rent in advance at all times when people want houses. And so young people who want to start life and who have very little money to pay for decent homes are forced to go and borrow money, and it stifles their ability to progress. And so it is something that we all are looking out for and wanting to see a solution to. And we hope that the present administration will continue what the past administration has done as a mark of precedence that will be left so that subsequent governments can see housing as a key area where we don't play politics about. Because, Mr. Speaker, we are in a critical need.